everyone, my name is Sam and thanks for checking out this video. Make sure to hit the subscribe button down below and give the video a thumbs up. So in this video, I wanted to give my thoughts and reviews on Batman Nightwalker by Marie Lu. It's a pretty hyped book. I've actually had quite a few people say to me when they found out I was reading it to let them know what I thought of it because they're kind of unsure about it because Marie Lu is not an author that they normally read, or they're afraid it's going to ruin it, or the length of it was kind of off-putting. To give you some of my personal tastes, for comparison, Marie Lu is not an instant buy author for me. I do own, I think, actually all of the published books that she has at this point, but I bought them off Book Depository after they were suggested to me by a couple other people, and I won't just automatically buy a book because she is the author for it. So far, I have read War Cross, which is the most recent release she's had before Batman. It was released in like mid to late, I think 2017, I want to say. People compare it to Ready Player One, but it is not even remotely close to being Ready Player One comparable. It's not a bad book by any means, but it is not Ready Player One. The real comparisons, they both have like a virtual reality kind of thing, so that's why people automatically just think it's the same thing. I have also read Legend by Marie Lu. This is the first book in the Legend trilogy. Like I said, I do own the other two and I will get to them. I'm just not a big dystopian binger, but this book wasn't bad. It was definitely a product of that dystopian hype phase though that we had. And I have also read the first two books of the Young Elites trilogy. It's kind of like the main character is kind of a villain kind of situation. So if you aren't aware, this is the second book in the DC Icon series. There's going to be four books here. We have Wonder Woman Warbringer, which came out last year by Leigh Bardugo. Then we have Batman Nightwalker. We are also getting Catwoman Soul Stealer by Sarah J. Maas in middle of 2018. And then in 2019, we are getting the Superman book. It has also been announced that they're doing a villains series, and it's going to be starting with Loki, which is being written by Mackenzie Lee, which should be really, really interesting. Now, with that said, Batman Nightwalker is definitely my favorite Marie Lu book that I have read. However, I did give it a 3.5 or 4 stars. I don't think I gave it the 4. I want to say 3.5. My biggest complaint about this book is it is under everything. And by that, I mean the world is underdeveloped, the characters are underdeveloped, the relationships are underdeveloped. It depends a lot on you already having some general idea of everyone and all the relationships and all the connections going on in the background. Alfred is pretty one-dimensional. They just kind of like, oh, and there's Alfred, he's his guardian. That's kind of it. They kind of name drop Harvey, they name drop Detective Gordon. So despite not really supposing to be a part of, you know, the Batman world that we know existing, you kind of have to have already some background on it to totally understand it and pick up on all the things. Luckily for me, Batman is my favorite superhero. I don't read, I think I've read 2 or so of the comics, so I'm not massive in that world of comics and graphic novels related to with superheroes in them, but I have 2 brothers who were, so just by osmosis being around them, I picked it up, as well as, you know, watching the movies and just being around this. It's such a big fandom. So the actual plot of this book is what I really enjoyed the most. It has Bruce Wayne as an 18-year-old kid. It starts on the day of his birthday. He is an orphan at this point. Alfred is his guardian. He has inherited all the billions that his parents left him after they got killed. And it starts off with a car chase, which eventually leads to him having to serve community hours. And for some reason, they decide to place him doing community service in the Arkham Insane Asylum. So, I mean, once again, if you know the Batman world, you know what the Arkham Asylum is, where he meets an interesting character named, I'm going to try and make sure I say her name properly throughout this whole video, but it's Madeline. I have a feeling I'm going to slip and say Madeline a few times, but nonetheless. So there are a ragtag group of, I guess, troublemakers who are breaking in, robbing, and murdering wealthy people living in Gotham. She, at the very beginning of the book, before you actually even meet Bruce, it's just like a couple pages on like how she gets caught. And then it jumps to her being in the Arkham Asylum in like the intensive care, locked away, seclusion kind of area, where Bruce, once again, for some reason, is allowed to go serve community services cleaning. As I'm saying it, I'm realizing how kind of ridiculous the plot can sound. And honestly, they begin to form a relationship. She starts to manipulate him and things kind of go all crazy and you learn more about the Nightwalkers. I really wish there had been a little bit more time put into the relationship with Bruce and his friend Harvey and Diana. I mean, it was just so, like, fleeting and last, like, kind of just thrown in between other scenes. But I really did enjoy them and their dynamic because it's very clear that they are important to each other. And at very difficult points in everyone's lives, they are each other's support system through, family, an abusive parent or parents dying and all this kind of stuff. And it is really interesting that he's found a couple people that are truly going to love him and take care of him and support him, even though he has billions of dollars. And that is something that he brings up immediately at the beginning, that he has a hard time trusting people because of that. So I wish there would have been more time put into that. I was actually really surprised at, like, the twist end villain thing at the end. I wasn't totally sure, like, I understood plot what was going on, but I wasn't totally sure who was good and who was bad. I had some feelings and vibes about everyone, but I mean, like, in the end, I was really happy with how the whole book went overall, especially with, like, the betrayal and everything like that. Something that I liked and disliked was the romance in this book. I feel like it could have been written without it. Like, it wasn't a key element because Bruce and Madeline are drawn to each other because of their minds, really, from the whole. Their minds and their personalities overall seem to, they kind of stand out for each other in each other's lives. Madeline, for obvious reasons, for Bruce, but, Bruce also, as well as she is working for the Nightwalkers who are trying to, get back at corrupt rich people, who she meets Bruce and she realizes that he's not exactly what, the Nightwalkers dictate him to be. That being said, the romance that did exist wasn't bad. It wasn't super, super sappy. And I think that is part of the reasoning is because it's under everything. Like, it wasn't super developed. It wasn't super hyped up. It wasn't built up. It just was there, which, I mean, it fit the book and it fit my taste, but I know looking at it that it could have been much better. I feel like Lou was trying to, like, vaguely reference or kind of draw attention to Bruce's, like, ability. He almost, like, blacks out when he gets angry violent and, like, which was interesting on its own. I mean, he gets angry violent in justifiable cases, but it was almost like she was hinting that, like, something is going on beneath and under it and everything, where I didn't quite understand why that was needed. I mean, he's rich. He's got lots of cool toys and everything like that. But again, too, he's rich. He's got lots of cool toys, but they don't really go into it. It's honestly, I understood what she was trying to do. It's too short of a book, and she didn't do enough with it. It should have been an extra 100, 150 pages, because like I said, it's only 250 pages long. It should have been almost double the size, and they could have gone into real, real detail and actually really, really cool stuff about the gears and the gadgets. They just kind of half mentioned Wayne Corp and all the tech stuff, and then they just mentioned, like, oh, bank account. This is how you stop someone from hacking your bank account. And, ooh, here's a pretty fast car that can, like, do stuff. That was it. There wasn't enough of the things that are very distinctly Batman and what make me love Batman so much. Overall, this book is not bad. However, it is nowhere near the quality, in my opinion, of Wonder Woman Warbringer. There is a lot of good things and a lot of interesting things about that book. This book was very plain. I honestly don't know that without the Batman label slapped on it, that this book would necessarily fly off the shelves. It's very much dependent on the already existing hype and the already existing knowledge. This book did kind of end, though, with the potential for a sequel, which is actually really interesting. I would love to get to see more of Madeline. She is really interesting as a character, and once again, she just doesn't get enough screen time because the book is too short. That is the real hindrance for this book. It's too short. There is either too much cut out or not enough put into it to begin with, because the things that I loved were kind of in here, but just not enough. So overall, I enjoyed it. Like I said, this is my favorite book by Marie Lu that I've read. However, I gave it a 3.5 stars, and it's definitely nowhere near what Wonder Woman Warbringer was. And honestly, I don't think it's going to even be able to compare to Catwoman Soul Stealer by Sarah J. Maas, because Maas is able to do some pretty amazing things. I hope that helped you, and I hope that if you do read this book that you enjoy it. Let me know if you have read it and what you think on it in the comment section down below. Make sure to check the description box as well for links to all of my social media. I am on Litzy, on Goodreads, on Instagram, on Twitter, and if you follow me, I will follow you back.